This illustration is describing about a block sliding over another block on an incline. Here we are given that a block A of mass m on an inclined surface and a weight B is attached to a string as shown in figure. And we are required to determine the acceleration of blocks A and B after the system is released from rest. Now, in this situation, first we distribute the forces. Let's have a look on the forces in this figure. Here, if the tension in a string is T, and if we talk about normal reaction, one normal reaction N1 will act on the block due to incline, and another normal reaction will be between block A and B, and say it is N2. Now, in this situation, if we draw the free body diagram of A and free body diagram of B, then here you can see A will experience its weight mg in downward direction. This is the reference line along and perpendicular to incline if this angle is theta. Then one tension would be acting on this block A along the surface, this T, and one T is acting on it in the direction normal to incline, this T. And one normal reaction N1 is acting over here, and one normal reaction due to the block B N2 is acting in this direction. And in this situation, say block A is sliding down with acceleration A. For block B, if we draw the free body diagram, it will experience its weight, a small mg in downward direction. Here also, if we draw the reference lines, and the normal reaction N2 is acting on it in this direction, and tension is acting in this direction. When block A slides down with acceleration A, we can see B will also come along A, as well as it will have an acceleration A in upward direction. So it will have two acceleration, one is here and other is here. Now in this situation, if we draw the equation of motion for the block, here you can see for the block A, we can write N2 plus mg sine theta minus T is equals to MA. So this is our first equation. And for block B, we can write two equations, one along the incline, other is normal to incline. So this will be small mg sine theta, as this angle is theta here. Small mg sine theta minus N2 is equals to small MA, the second equation. And normal to the inclined direction, we can write this as T minus small mg cos theta is equals to small MA. That is our third equation. Here, if we add these equations, you can see T and N2 gets cancelled out. And here we are getting the result as M plus small mg sine theta minus mg cos theta is equals to M plus twice small m A. If we continue here, we are getting the value of acceleration A, which is that of the block A, and is given as M plus small m sine theta minus small m cos theta divided by M plus 2m multiplied by G. This is the value of acceleration of block A. For block B, we can write, here also we can write this as acceleration of block A. For block B, as it is moving along with A with acceleration A and going up with acceleration A, so acceleration of B can be written as resultant of these two acceleration, which is root 2 A. We can substitute the value to get the acceleration of block B, which is root 2 times g multiplied by m plus capital M sine theta minus m cos theta divided by capital M plus twice small m. So these are the final results of accelerations of blocks A and B.